we can speak to all these different issues. So, what's really helped us kind of, I guess, go viral is we go and we do lots of unscripted town halls. Like we just go and open up the floor to questions and talk to people. And Byron will video most of it. He'll either live stream it or he'll video it and he'll cut up different clips. And that shows people, hey, this is how Joe feels on these different issues. And that's resonating with people because, again, people don't like the dodgy answer of, I just want to go do things that are really great for my community and I'm in this to fight for all of you. I mean, that gets you only so far. They want to actually hear that you have substance, how you're going to bring back manufacturing, how our jobs have been affected out here with the gutting of the timber industry. And then they want to hear about the issues of the day, like Matt was talking about with January 6th. I mean, people want to hear where you stand because they hear politicians, especially Republicans, dodge that question all the time. Election integrity, that's another huge one. If you're not talking about election integrity, a lot of folks out here in Washington State, and I think this is the same throughout the country, they tune out. They want to hear exactly what you know and what you plan to do to fix it because the average American, they know something bad happened in 2020 and they want the truth and they want to hear where you stand. So I think just staying as honest and on message about what you believe and being forthright with people is refreshing. They don't want business as usual politicians.
So Byron, can we get some updated like Joe Kemp polling information, because the last data I saw you guys were just surging in the name ID you were getting out there, and you're doing it without spending a lot of money on television and mailers and the type of stuff that traditionally goes with this type of bump in name ID and ballot test, or is it just the power of that Trump endorsement? Folks are understanding that this is the Western front of the America First battle, and you guys are getting your due credit as a result.
Well, the Trump endorsement certainly helped. So we were at 23%, according to Trafalgar, prior to the Trump endorsement. We're now at 31%. But it's important to note that this is a top two primary. So you have every Democrat, every Republican is on the ballot in the primary, top two advance to the general. Jamie's down at 23% as an incumbent. And among Republicans, she's only at 25%. And there aren't that many Democrats supporting her. And at the end of the day, they will vote for the Democrat candidate. And we had a debate last week between Joe and the Democrat on the most popular radio program out here in the district. And people know it's now a two-horse race, and the incumbent is just, she's fading away. But she does have Larry.
She won't even be on the ballot. Let me make a prediction. Jamie Herrera Butler will not be even on the ballot.
Probably not.
She will be, look, she is one of these folks who is out there hustling on K Street, hoping that with K Street favor, there is a future in East Coast Washington, not West Coast Washington for her.